This is the summer that I turned brave. There's unresolved conflicts in my family that I've let fester for too long because I'm scared of how hard things will be once I'm honest about them. But hey, I've turned 16 this summer. It's time to grow up, right? I'm with Sammy. We're gonna get some boba before I leave for my trip. I was just like, I need to hang out with someone, I feel like, before I leave. Something I've been discovering this summer is my true worth outside of my productivity, outside of being a YouTuber or a young entrepreneur. I've spent the last 2 years of my life growing up extremely fast. Honestly, I feel like this whole summer, God has kind of given me the opportunity to have an immersive healing process. First trip I had this summer was to the Dominican Republic on a missions trip with my church. And I feel like God sent me on this trip to heal my relationship with him because I was really far from God, guys. And then the next trip I went on was a siblings trip to Europe, so London and Paris with my siblings. And I felt like God needed to heal my relationship with my siblings too. We haven't ever been like super distant, but I felt distant from my siblings. I could tell. And I didn't feel like a genuine love towards them because I felt so disconnected. And I feel so close to them now after that trip. But definitely on that trip, I noticed I was still holding some resentment for my parents and still feeling really distant from my parents. So I feel like God is like sending me on this family trip as like the last kind of healing stepping stone of this summer, which is to heal my relationship with my parents. Do I really honor my parents like as much as I could honor them? Not really. I truly believe that healing will happen on this trip. To take a pause, I've done some countercultural things. I've intentionally stayed up late watching The Summer I Turned Pretty because it inspired me to get back in touch with my teenage energy. I'm currently reading The Way of the Shepherd. It is a leadership book that I kind of assigned as homework for my internship that I'm currently doing. It's really good. While most people are trying to adopt a productive summer morning routine, I've been shifting my schedule to later nights and sleeping in a bit later so that I can be on the same schedule as my family to learn how to slow down and invest more time into my relationships. I'm really excited for tomorrow and to just start off this trip, and I feel like this is gonna sound pretty dramatic, but I honestly feel like a new person this summer just because I've spent so much time just like learning and investing into growing my relationships and just like understanding who I am outside of the things that I do, because I feel like I was just really caught up in like literally defining my worth by my productivity and like the professional things that I do. Like, it feels weird. I feel like I've had so many different like character changes within myself in this last year, like maybe three. Humans are constantly changing and evolving. It's insane. And sometimes it's hard to like go through so much change on camera because sometimes I have the insecurity like, what if my personal brand isn't consistent or I say something that I disagree with 2 months from now? I think you guys understand that I'm a changing teenager and
that's normal.
I hope so. Honestly, putting my clothes in this closet genuinely feels like self-care because like 2 months ago I would have said that this is not a productive use of my time and would have been living out of my suitcase this entire trip.
I've learned a lot through this season of life, of slowing down, but it's weird for my family to accept. I've made lots of sacrifices to invest my time into this YouTube channel, my coaching business, productivity, like quitting sports and instruments. My mom doesn't agree with those sacrifices, but she was able to stomach them when I was ultra-productive. But now that I'm not ultra-productive in this season, I don't really know what's left. But my goal is to reintroduce myself to my parents on this trip.
To be honest, the church service that we just went to was brutal to get through. And I feel bad saying that as a Christian, but I did not resonate with it.
I want to be accepted in a slow season and in a grind season.
Good evening. I'm a little mentally like shook right now because I just had like an hour long conversation with a friend and it was a difficult conversation to have like on the phone call and took a lot of emotional energy from me, but I'm so glad that I had it and it was really good. Growing opportunity for me and my friend, but just a lot. This summer, I'm getting better at relationships and also just like confronting issues head on with other people, and it's uncomfortable. I don't really have a specific agenda for this meeting, but I'm thinking you can kind of update me on the projects you've been working on.
Today was quite chill in Quebec, but got quite heavy later in the night.
My what beef is.
To
be honest, tonight's been kind of tough. There's been a lot of family beefing.
I feel like before we take a family picture, we should resolve our beef.
What beef?
Has the beef been resolved?
I think it's a lifelong beef.
Why are you normalizing this?
When I was constantly working without rest, I got out of touch with my emotions. I forgot how sensitive I truly am because when I was so busy, I felt like I didn't have the time to let myself be sad about relationships. It was hard to let myself get close to people because I didn't have the energy to deal with conflicts that arise when you let people into your heart. Here's the thing, my parents are wonderful people. They have pure intentions. However, sometimes we struggle to understand each other. We struggle to push past the logical arguments and truly express how our actions affect each other. So I bought my mom and me some matching hair clips. Got like a light purple one for her, and then this green one for me. Crying today was a challenge for me. I'm used to packaging up my true feelings into logical arguments, but I'm learning to speak without trying to sound collected or smart or like the CEO. To just be. To be 16-year-old daughter A.
Oh, my love, side to side.
What's easy?
I love right. You.
I love
you. It's important to define what it means to heal. For a family to heal means addressing problems and coming into agreement on the fact that we love each other. It's not about everything being picture perfect. God is still helping my family and I understand each other. Solutions are helpful, but it's not solutions that truly heal a broken heart. However, I have begun hypothesizing a few systems for growing closer to my parents once we come home.
I have actually set up like a system that I'm really excited about to spend time with my parents. When I was like just so focused on productivity all the time, I thought that the way to make my parents proud of me, the way to make them happy is just to work so hard. But then because I was just working so hard, I wasn't actually spending time with them, and I realized that's what they really need. So what I'm doing from now on is Mondays are going to be my mommy daughter day with my mom. So after school, during the school year, we're gonna hang out. And then on Sunday, it's gonna be like my daddy daughter day. So Sunday after church, gonna get lunch with my dad or do some type of activity with him. I definitely think just like dedicating days to intentionally spend time with your parents is actually so underrated. A lot of my relationship with my parents has just been through convenience and passing by time, but I want to show them I care about you. I want to prioritize you. I want to actually dedicate a day to spend time with you and do that weekly. Treat your relationship with your parents like you would treat an actual relationship, right?
Working on a weekend like usual, way off in the deep end like usual. Niggas swear they passed us, they doing too much. Haven't done my taxes, I'm too turned up.
I typically never do work on the bed, and I advise against it, but on this family trip, I think doing the work I need to do in this bed is the best place to do it. So I'm a big champion for just unplugging on family trips and just trips in general, but the thing is I've traveled so much this summer, and the last two trips I went to, I like really unplugged from my devices for the most part, so it's kind of like I can fully unplug if I really want to. I'm not a slave to my computer, but there genuinely are some brand deals stuff that I need to do, and honestly, I'm blessed to be able to do the work that I do. So at the end of the day, I'm grateful. It can just be a little difficult to kind of find this work-life balance when you can do work on vacation. Sometimes my family gets frustrated with the amount of like time I spend working, and I've definitely been getting better at it and like making sacrifices to spend time with them, but I feel like right now is a good time to work, and like I have spent enough time with them, so I feel fine.
I just realized that I'm always asking my parents to trust me more and give me more freedom, but I failed to put my trust in them. I often doubt that they have my best interest at heart, even when my mentors and counselors tell me so. How can I expect them to trust me when I don't even trust them? And I'm learning how to interpret my mom's acts of service as unconditional love instead of latching onto the words she says when she's in a bad mood. Our parents are human too. They make mistakes. They say things they later wish they could take back, just like you and I do. Quebec has been an opportunity to heal my relationship with them and explore my own identity, but things tend to be easier on vacation. I think we all know that. The real test is life back in Massachusetts. But I guess you'll have to subscribe and like to see that.